never travelled on a train until I was 19. I wasn't allowed to go out by myself. So many factories these days. More houses. I think it's sad, really.
Hello. I nearly knocked you over in the car, remember? Near the shopping centre. Should be more careful. You weren't watching where you were going.
I'm sorry.
Don't apologise.
Senior Sergeant Madden, this gentleman claims that a young boy was knocked down by a car outside here.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You do have a son?
Yes, he's perfectly all right.
Was he hit by a car?
He's all right.
Would you mind if I just took a look at him? Can I come inside?
Why do you want to see inside my house?
I just want to see if the boy needs medical attention.
Don't you trust me? Don't you think I'm capable of looking after him?
If I could just come inside.
What are you all staring at? Why are you picking on me? Go away!
Neighbour, any help?
No, he's only confirmed what we know.
Dr. Young, any developments?
No, only that I think we can be pretty sure that she's mentally disturbed.
If she's likely to hurt the child, we should force an entry.
No, that could make matters worse. She's armed and she's potentially violent. We can't risk further injury to the boy.
You're quite sure the child is injured?
Yes, but we don't know how badly. We do have a witness to the accident, though.
Let me have a try.
Mrs. Lane? I'm a doctor. I'm here to help you.
I don't want your help. Wake up, darling. Mummy's here.
Mrs. Lane, I'm by myself. The police have gone. Will you please open the door?
I don't know.
Have you got the key?
We'll need an ambulance.
On the way.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt him. He wanted you, Jack.
I'm here, son.
How's he, Doctor? Is he badly hurt?
That's internal injuries, I'd say.
Will he be all right?
Come along, Mrs. Lane. It's all over now. Take it easy.
Dr. Johnson,
how have you been?
Mr.
I'm sorry, Ben. That's not much good saying that, I suppose. He'll be all right. You should have let him in.
Giving orders again, Jack.
Well?
We're about to operate. We'll know in an hour.
What's wrong with him?
He's hemorrhaging.
I didn't know.
I suggest you take your wife home, Mr. Lane.
Thank you.
Why do I fight?
Give it to me.
So you want you to run out on me? Snivelling, double-crossing bitch. How long has this been going on? How long? I'll get the truth out of you, the last thing I do.
That's the hardest part to take, Inspector. Ben was always against violence. Said he'd never use a gun unless it was to save a life. Do you think it might have saved him if he'd been different?
No, Mrs. Hunter, I think your son was quite right to feel as he did about violence. And I doubt if he had a chance to use his gun last night.
I've checked. They haven't seen it.
Thanks. Pat back?
Mm.
Send him in, will you? And see if he can get young Redford to arrange some black coffee.
What about you, Mrs. Hunter?
Could I have a cup of tea?
It's on its way.
You've all been very kind.
Would you like me to call your sister-in-law?
I'll manage.
Inspector?
Oh. Mrs. Hunter's collected her son's effects, but there's a small St. Christopher medallion missing.
Well, I don't remember it. It could be the mortuary.
Harry checked that.
I'm sorry to be such a nuisance. I know you've been up all night. It's just that... Well, it was given to him by his late father.
We understand, Mrs. Hunter.
Well, I've got no one now. They're both gone. Thank you, Pat.
Are you going to ring your sister-in-law and I'll hang around for a while?
I'll be all right on my own.
Yes. I've got nothing else to do. Well, I'll take the washing in for you.
Don't bother, I'll do it later.
It's okay. Now go and phone your sister-in-law.
The money for the electrician's in the drawer by the phone. I mentioned it before I left this morning. No, Mum, I wouldn't want you to write out a check. I'll have to go, Mum. Yes. Yes, I will. Bye.
You know why I'm here. Yes, Jen?
Mr. Burke's here, Mr. Donovan.
Send him in. Slip into something more comfortable, and I'll be right back.
Jean Ford speaking. Oh, yes, Mr. Donovan.
I'm trying to get in touch with Victoria Stafford. Would you have an address or a telephone number?
She does a lot of work from home. I think I have her address here. Flat 6.
All right, hang on a second. Here you go. Good. Thank you very much, Jane. Sorry to trouble you.
That's all right, Mr. Donovan. Good night.
Who was that, Jean?
Mr. Donovan, Mum.
Well, what did he want?
It was just business.
You're not going out?
No, Mum, I'm not going out.
Oh, Jean, sorry to interrupt your lunch, but is Mr. Donovan in?
No, he's in the theaterette at the moment, Don. Will I get him to call you?
No, that's all right. I'll catch up with him later. It's just a query about the new roster. Hey, what are you doing sitting here anyway? Why aren't you up at the canteen having lunch?
Oh, I just like a quiet read. It's a bit noisy up there.
Oh, you're just plain antisocial. We never see you at the pub and you never come to the Beverly Crest.
I don't drink much. I don't seem to fit in very well.
Hey, have you been to one of the wind downs after the show? Because believe me, you'd fit in there. Everyone just relaxes, you know, and no one cares about anything much.
Where's this?
It's at the Beverly Crest. They give us a private room. Hey, why don't you come tonight?
Couldn't just turn up.
Of course you could. Better still, you come round after the show and I'll take you along.
That's awfully kind of you, Don.
It's a date. Tonight, after the show, and not another word.
Is Mr. Donovan there?
No, Mr. Knight. He's in the theatreette. He just came in.
Would you ask him to come and see me, Miss Wall?
I'm on the way.
I
I never did like that dress on you, Jean. Why don't you wear the nice green taffeta you bought for Elsie's wedding? You got the gloves to match.
No one wears gloves anymore, Mum.
Oh, well, of course, I'm out of date. I mean, I would have thought that 10 o'clock was far too late to be going out.
Probably is, Mum.
Lord knows what they'd wear. I wouldn't.
No, Mum, you wouldn't. And so all poor Tony could say was, but madam, I can't arrest you. I'm not a real policeman. I'd like to ask you in for a cup of coffee, Don, but Mum will be waiting.
Yeah, that's all right, don't worry.
I've enjoyed myself. It's really been great fun. And you were very kind.
We'll do it again. Soon.
Sorry, love, it said Mr. Donovan on the door. You're Jean Ford. I'm Lee Whiteman.
Oh, Mr. Donovan's expecting you.
Oh, don't worry with all that triz.
Oh, look at me. You're back already. I'm sorry, Stuart. How are you? Oh, you must be worn out, I expect. How was Sydney? Oh, I was hoping to get this cake baked before you got back. It's your favourite. Well, sit down, everyone. I'll make a cup of tea. Father'd like a cup of tea, I expect, and Peter too.
Louise!
Bert Kennedy rang, he told me.
Look, it's not half as bad as it sounds, Mrs. Morgan. Julie didn't mean to do it.
Why did you have to go to a man like that for a job in the first place? Isn't this good enough for you anymore?
It was because of the Contessa,
what,
Mr.
You?
Morgan!
I thought if I got a job, it'd help pay for things. For the Contessa.
Then you needn't have bothered. I've sold your bloody horse. What got into her? What made her do a thing like that? You're going to have to talk to her, Louise.
Me talk to her?
Well, you're her mother, aren't you? You're supposed to understand these things.
I don't see why I should understand any more than you do. Why don't you talk to her?
I can't do everything myself, Louise. Ah. This is a job for you, all right?
Sorry. Yes, I'll talk to her. Oh, before I forget, we still owe Pete for 2 weeks' money. Can you fix him up?
Well, I left you enough money to cover everything when I went away. What are you doing with it?
I spent it. I had to get some more chicken feed. The mould had got into the other.
Oh, it's all right when I left. Remember, check. Nothing wrong with it.
I'm sorry.
Oh, Louise, you don't have to apologise. Oh, you're upset. I'm upset. It's only natural after what she's done. She's humiliated me with them.
Well, rushing in like you did wouldn't have helped things much.
Oh, I suppose you're saying it's all my fault. I'm the one to blame.
Stuart, you're not really going to sell the Contessa, are you? I mean, you didn't mean what you said.
Meant every word of it.
It'll break her heart.
The Contessa goes, Louise. I thought at least you'd understand. We're broke. In debt. My name's Mud in the horse game. The only hope I've got left is to sell the Contessa and try to make a fresh start. Though heaven knows it's going to be hard enough after today. I'll be the laughing stock of Matlock.
Is that all you care about? Your good name?
Yes. That's all I care about. I've got nothing else, have I?
Peter thinks it might rain today.
Where is he? Why isn't he having breakfast with us?
Oh, he won't be long. He just went to get the Contessa in before the rain started. Butter, dear.
What are you doing today, Stuart? I just thought if you had some spare time, you might help me fix the sewing machine.
Mr. Morgan, the Countess is missing. She's been stolen.
Poor Pete. He's so worried. You like Peter, don't you?
Of course I like him. Don't you?
Yes, I don't know what we'd do without him, but that's not what I meant. It's a bit more than that, isn't it?
And if it is?
Your father would never allow it.
It's nothing to do with my father, or you for that matter.
You don't understand. Your father and I want you to be happy.
Happy? That's a laugh.
Now, let me finish. We do want you to be happy more than anything else in the world. I know this may sound mercenary, but without money, none of it's possible.
Do you think the money from the Contessa is going to make me happy?
Julie, you've got your whole life before you. You don't understand all these things yet. You haven't had enough
experience. Oh, I know what it's all about. I'm not a child. And I'll tell you why I like Pete. Because he's the only one who cares. Do you know how long it is since anybody, you or Dad or anybody, treated me like a girl and not like some awful sideshow freak?
Julie, don't ever say that. Don't call yourself
why
that.
Why not? It's true. Yesterday in Matlock didn't happen because I'm pretty or even plain. It happened because I'm ugly.
No.
And men don't want to look at me because I embarrass them.
No!
Yes! And that's why you never put your arms around me or even say I love you.
No, that's not true.
But you've never said it to me. Not even once. You'd better come in.
Thank you.
Mum, this is Sergeant Malone.
Was the Contessa insured?
No.
Yes. Yes, I meant to tell you, but with all the trouble we've had, I insured her while you were away with the feed money. I was afraid something might happen, and when you got back, there'd be nothing.
Yes, I know it's been a shock, Mr. Jenkins. Well, this morning we had the police here. We're doing everything in our power to find her. Well, we'll ring you when we get her back. Yes, I put an ad in the local paper. $2,000 reward. Yes, that's right. All right, Mr. Jenkins. We'll be seeing you. Oh, this is lovely, this is. Wouldn't he take you with him? No, I suppose not. He's had his bit of fun.
It's not like that. He's different.
Yeah, don't fool yourself, girl. It's always like that when the boss's daughter sleeps around with the hands.
It wasn't wrong. What we did, it wasn't.
Now, what are you trying to tell
me? Stop it! I can't stand it anymore.
Mum.
This is Julie's home. This is where she belongs. I've never been so ashamed in my life of both of you.
Well, I suppose you're right, Louise. But it comes right down to it. No matter. We'll never be rid of you.
Phone number, I'll give him a ring.
Mm.
Stuart. Julie's gone. She's packed her bags and caught the bus out.
Gone? Gone where?
Where do you think? She's gone to Peter. What did you expect after the way you've been treating her? And then the news about the Contessa. She's broken, Stuart. She needs to be with Peter. Face up to it, Stuart. It's all our fault that this whole thing happened.
What do we do?
You've hardly touched your lunch, Bill. I know the doctor told you to get your weight down, but you're not supposed to make yourself ill. It takes time, love.
Crash dieting, that's what it is. I've seen some of these young girls doing it, starving themselves to death.
Would you like me to ring the goods yard? Tell them that you're not well enough to go to work tonight.
Oh, no.
I saw one of them. She was down to 6 stone. No flesh on her bones.
Mum, Bill's blood pressure's too high. That's all.
Huh.
Missing his smokes, love.
Yes, I'm a bit.
Couldn't you have just one? Say after a meal.
Better not. Well, I'll be off now.
Don't walk too far.
Don't walk too far. far as the TAB, I wouldn't wonder.
You've got no right to criticise, Mum. Bill's a good husband. Are you sure you feel well enough to go to work, love?
I'm fine.
You'll get your blood pressure down, Bill. I don't think you should worry too much about it. Bill, is anything else bothering you?
Anything else? No, of course not, Selma. What's that?
It's a phone number. Mum found it in the pocket of your shirt when she was sorting out the wash.
She would. Oh, that's probably some rail carrier had to ring about something, though it doesn't come to mind who, though.
I rang the number, Bill. A woman answered. Said she was Ida Lee. Who is she, Bill? Is she a friend of yours?
What do you say? A load of lies, I'll be bound.
It's the home number of one of the goods loaders.
Oh, yes?
Now, Mum, that's all there is to it.
Your father was pretty good at making excuses, too.
Bill isn't my dad. Well, he isn't. Dad wasn't a patch on Bill, and you know it.
Still, waters run deep, I always say.
Well, just remember this. It's Bill that opened his doors to you when none of your sons would. Both Jack and Francis are earning more than Bill does. But he's the one who shares what he's got with you. Now, just remember that next time you feel like pulling him to pieces.
Trouble, love?
It's nothing. Mum sometimes doesn't appreciate when she's well off, that's all. Ready for lunch?
Yes, I am. Not too much, though. Any mail?
Nothing much.
Bills?
The insurance payment.
God almighty, never have your hand out of your pockets these days.
We'll manage. Bill, you sure there's nothing else worrying you that you haven't told me about?
Now, what could be wrong? We get by, don't we?
Yes, we do. Working at night, I see no sense in it.
Neither do I, Mum.
Working when it's dark, sleeping when it's light, it just won't do.
Now, Mum.
Well, it won't, leaving two defenceless women alone in the house at night.
Never thought of you as being defenceless, Mum.
In the old days, perhaps. But now, with all these sorts of criminals around, they'd kill you for your pension.
Bye, Bill. Now, keep warm.
We could all be murdered in our beds and nobody'd know any different.
See you in the morning. Night, Mum.
What about that thing you found today? Did you show him that, Thelma?
What's that?
I'll get it.
It was just inside our front gate. That's it. What was it doing in our garden, I'd like to know?
That's a tire lever. Some kid's probably chucked it there.
Tire lever, he says. That's the sort of thing they break into your house with and murder you in your bed.
What an imagination.
Well, I'll give it to one of the boys that owns a car. Good night. See you in the morning.
You're far too soft with him, Thelma. A man's place is at home with his wife at night. I think he does night shift because it suits him. I can read him like a book. And he's up to no good, believe me.
So there is a woman after all. You liar, Bill. You rotten liar.
Home, Thelma. For God's sake, please get me home. Can't you see I'm ill?
Who the hell are you?
Easy on.
No, who are you?
I'm Detective Johnson. This is Detective Francis. We're making some inquiries about a number of house breakings in the area.
Just calm down.
Calm down? I wouldn't need you sergeants to save my life. They were filthy. Absolutely filthy.
You did the right thing.
Right thing?
His sandwiches look as if they came straight from the gutters of Naples.
Hold on now. Look, you go into a milk bar, refuse to pay for what you've ordered, and make an almighty row about it. Mr. Vilas, out of the goodness of his heart, brings you here to me instead of the police. Now, take it easy. Be thankful. And try sobering up. Hmm?
And who are you?
Joe Carroll. Or Father Carroll, if you prefer.
Well, that was a magnificent sermon, Father. Pity it isn't Sunday. Well, I'll be off now.
Sure you can make it?
I'll be perfectly all right. Thank you so much. On second thoughts, perhaps I should avail myself of your toilet before I leave. Where is it?
Of course, it's the end of the hall.
Don't touch me. I can manage.
I hope to still have your feet up.
I'm quite all right now, thanks.
I don't know your name.
I'm sorry, Eileen Courtney.
Joe Carroll.
Oh, yes, Father Carroll, I remember. I'm afraid I was rather under the weather.
Oh, that's all right.
No, it's not. I'm sure I was very rude. You see, I'm just not used to drinking.
I see.
Yes, the fact is, I got a bit upset this morning.
What, is it Mrs. Courtney?
Yes.
What upset you?
Well, I suppose it was nothing very much, really, but we middle-aged women are so neurotic. I was supposed to meet my daughter to go shopping. I waited and waited, but she didn't turn up. Then I began to wonder if I'd got it all wrong, you know, the way you do. And before I knew where I was in a proper state. So I went into a bar to have a brandy to steady my nerves.
Just the one?
A double. Come to think of it, I had another. And as I say, I'm not used to it at all.
Well, would you like to phone your daughter from here?
Oh, no. I already rang her from the hotel, and she was just about to go out somewhere else. Like a silly fool, I'd got the day wrong. Well, you've been very kind. Perhaps if I could ring a taxi.
Yes, of course.
Oh, I've just remembered. I lost my wallet.
Oh, really? Any idea where?
Yes. I first missed it in that shop. That's why I didn't pay the man.
Oh, not just the Neapolitan sandwiches.
Don't remind me. The thing is, it must have been stolen. I had it when I left home.
Stay right where you are. I've got a friend who's a detective at Riverside Police Station. I'm sure she'll be delighted to help. Sit down, please.
How much money was in the wallet, Mrs. Courtney? About $75.
Oh, that's too bad.
Oh, that's not what's worrying me. It's the personal things. There were photographs of my daughter and the grandchildren, and the wallet itself. It was rather special. It was one of the last things my husband gave me before he died.
How long ago was that?
2 years. Eric Courtney, you know. I thought perhaps you might have known him. He was a very successful businessman, quite a public figure.
No, I'm sorry.
Oh, never mind, you can't know everyone.
You must miss him a lot.
Yes, a lot. It takes quite a while to get used to being alone, doesn't it? But I'm managing.
That's the way. We must get back to exactly where you think you might have lost that wallet.
Well, it had definitely gone by the time I got to the sandwich shop.
And where were you before then?
Well,
The pub wouldn't it have been?
Yes, I'm afraid. I suppose so.
Which one?
The Alamein?
That's the one.
Well, don't worry too much. We've had quite a lot of reports of theft in the neighborhood. We often catch up with them and recover the stuff. In the meantime, I'll check with lost property. Would you like a lift home? It's on my way.
Oh, yes, thank you.
You wouldn't have room for me, I suppose. I've got a little call to make over that way.
Oh, I think I could squeeze you in.
Yes, I had this feeling that we were going to meet again. Please, sit down.
Thank you. In a better light this time, I hope. I just came to tell you that the police have found my wallet and I've got it back.
Oh, yes, yes, I heard.
And to thank you for putting up with me.
What makes you think you're so hard to take?
Oh, come now. I was a handful yesterday morning. I know I was. I should know by now that liquor doesn't suit me.
Well, it's just as well you don't drink very often.
When my husband was alive, I hardly touched it. A gin before dinner, perhaps, when he was having his whiskey. A glass or two of champagne at parties.
And now?
Well, I'll be honest, it has become a bit of a temptation. It's getting used to being alone, you see. I've never been very good at that, and sometimes a drink or two makes the prospect a little less bleak.
Yesterday morning, for instance.
Yes, I had the blues properly.
Do you think you can go on chasing them away with a bottle?
Oh, no, I'm not as silly as that. In fact, I'm not going to drink any more from now on. After all, I couldn't bear to run the risk of becoming an alcoholic.
Take your hands off me, you little runt!
Now, madam, a little decorum, thank you.
Decorum? He couldn't even pronounce it. I take it you've no objection if I sit down.
Yes, thank you, 279. The ambulance is on its way.
Drunk and disorderly, I'm afraid, seeing the size now wrong.
You don't say so, Baker. You don't say so.
What am I doing here? Will somebody please tell me what I'm doing here?
Well, if it isn't dear old Meg.
There must be a strike. It's the only explanation.
A strike?
Oh, this is what happens when there's a strike. We're locked in till they settle it.
How long will that be?
Could be days.
Days?
Or could be. Or it might be just a couple of hours. But there's no use in getting upset.
You seem to know a lot about prisons.
I've been inside for a couple of years.
What did you do?
Hid my husband and son after an armed hold-up, aiding and abetting. What about you?
I killed somebody. Shot her. The woman who murdered my mother.
I read about that in the papers. You're,
Rosalind Coulson.
That's right. I'm Pat O'Connell. I'm pleased to meet you. But what if you don't get your parole, Pat? You can't be sure about it, can you?
Well, there's no reason why I shouldn't.
You don't know for certain, though, do you?
As good as.
Is that correct, officer? Will Pat be paroled by Christmas?
There's no guaranteeing it. I mean, even if she does get a parole, it could be weeks before she's released. These things do take time, you know.
There you are, love. I just can't go on the way I am. I have to consider my health.
Oh, but Mum!
Unless you're out by next week, Pat, I'll have to put Emma and Andrew into a home.
I couldn't be happier.
We wanted to meet you.
Oh, don't be silly. Anyway, you're supposed to be staying off your feet.
Emma, darling.
Emma and me did that.
Oh, it's wonderful, Andrew.
Oh, look. Star.
There. Well, here's to having you home. And may the new year bring us all back together again.
Police, Mrs. O'Connell, we have a search warrant.
What's all this about? Can't you leave us in peace?
Your son's escaped from prison. We think he may be here.
Shane, what are you doing here?
Stay, he wants you.
Well, I can't come now. What if the cops are watching?
No, he's just over there.
He must be mad.
Who is it?
Who's he?
Oh, come on, Mrs. O'Connell, we ain't got much time.
What is it? It's David, isn't it? Pat, you can't go, love. You can't. What about the kids? I can't look after them with my legs. You want them to end up in a home?
Oh, Mum,
well, that's where they're going to end up if you get caught with David. You'll do your parole. You'll go back inside. They won't let me keep them in my condition.
Oh, I know, Mum. I know. But David's my kid, too.
Look, we ain't got much time. We're shooting through.
What? Where?
Well, me and Dave to New South.
But he promised. He said he'd give himself up.
He never said nothing about that, but he reckons he ain't going until he sees you.
You can't just run off like that.
Oh, look, I'm not sticking around any longer. Are you coming or not?
But you can't. I've got you, Mum. I've got to make him surrender.
Oh, we're not giving in, Missus.
He's got to give himself up. Pat!
Get down!
Prisoner for admittance.
Oh, O'Connell, what are you doing back here?
They never stay out for long. Stand on the white line.
Is this it?
Snap out of it. What's your name?
Patricia Mary Teresa O'Connell.
Consorting, breaking parole.
Your precious son again. You were charged with breaking parole by consorting with a known criminal. Is that correct? Is that correct?
Yes.
Now empty your pockets and put everything on the table. Then go behind that screen for a body search. Well, hurry up. I haven't got all day.
What happened?
You mean you haven't heard yet? There was a shootout at her place. Young O'Connell and one of his mates. She was found in their company.
Might have known.
The bastard killed one of our boys.
Have you got him yet?
No, but we will. And when we do...
Now, this is your statement. Listen to it carefully. I answered the doorbell on the day in question to Shane Berkeley. I had met him once or twice before and knew he was a friend of David's. He told me David was outside in a car and wanted to say goodbye before leaving the state. I decided to try and persuade him to give himself up. I went with Berkeley towards the car. We were only halfway when there were shots and Berkeley fell. Police arrived from several directions. The car drove off. I don't know if David was in it. I had not seen or heard from him since he escaped from prison and have not heard from him since. I have no knowledge of where he is at the present time. Do you have anything to add? You better sign that as a true and accurate record of his statement. Sergeant Reynolds, would you date and witness the signatures, please?
How are you, love?
All right.
You sure? Come, have a cigarette. You didn't do too well, eh?
You can say that again.
What, are you going to keep us in the dark or what?
Well, that kid, Herbie, confessed that I'd seen David, that's all.
What a bugger. Oh, I swear to God, this kid of mine's going to be brought up proper.
One of these days...
Oh, it doesn't matter, Bea. Look, she just doesn't think, that's all.
Are you trying for a sainthood?
O'Connell, the governor wants to see you.
Is it about the trial? Something's turned up, hasn't it?
Davey's going to be all right, isn't he? Mrs. Davidson? Sit down, Pat. Something's wrong. Pat, David hanged himself in his cell. He died an hour ago.
David O'Connell was found dead in his prison cell shortly after 3:30 this afternoon. There were no suspicious circumstances.
No one's to blame. No suspicious circumstances.
Pat, love. Pat. It's better this way, Pat. Pat, it was... Well, I mean, what did he have to look forward to, Pat? 50 years in the loony bin? Davy's dead!
No, Pat! No, Pat!
Sit down, Pat.
You kill him! You go on, Mom! And you go, Daddy! And it didn't matter to you, did it? No, the girl has said it before. It seems to be going all right, don't you think?
Yes, but don't be too confident.
But the judge said I'd been through a lot, and when you told them about Eric...
Pat, you've been convicted and sentenced. Now, for the judges to alter that sentence means, in effect, that they're admitting one of their colleagues was wrong, and they do not like to do that. The law, at least, must be seen to be unified.
The law. What about justice?
This court therefore rules that the sentence of 2 years be commuted to 6 months, this term to be served concurrently with the original sentence.
Thank you, Your Honor.
This court will now adjourn, sine die. God save the Queen. Silence. All stand.
Darlings.
Are you really coming home, Mum?
Yes, I am, sweetheart. This time for good. Thanks, Mrs. Jackson.
Goodbye,
Pat. I'll take that. Well, who wants to ride in the back seat with Mum?
Me.
Come on, then.
Oh, it's in trouble too.
It's been a very disappointing day, Mother.
Oh, now come on, you two. It's not the end of the world. Also, it's not every day I lash out and buy a bottle of wine like this either. To the future.
Yes, to the future.
It's just so sad when we'd made such great plans and everything. I'll be lucky if we can ever afford a place.
Oh, nonsense.
No, I was reading in the paper the other day where it said that everything's stacked against first home buyers.
Oh, yes, that's true.
It said no matter how much you save, you can never keep up with inflation or property value.
Oh, it's so difficult for young people nowadays. We'll just have to settle for something a little smaller, Myla.
I think we'll just have to settle for this place.
Oh, well, I never. Do you think that I bought this wine to celebrate doom and disaster? Not on your life. I'm afraid it's not a night for celebration, Mother. Well, I think it is. Listen, I've been thinking how I own my house outright and how I've managed to put something away. And I've decided to help you two along a bit. Now, wait a minute. Roy, listen. I can't take it with me, now can I? Much better if I help you too. Besides, I don't want my grandchildren to grow up here with nowhere to run and play.
Do you really mean it, Iris?
Well, of course I do. If a mother can't help her only son and his lovely wife, what can she do?
Morning, Miss Harrison.
Morning, Mrs. Tran.
This night work isn't doing your health any good.
I can take care of myself.
You make sure you get some decent sleep today. Miss Harrison? Who's there?
I'm a friend of Gina's. She's at the shops.
Oh. I brought her some dinner.
That's very kind of you.
I heard the other one breathing. I knew there was something funny about it. Poor Miss Harrison.
Yeah, well, thanks, Mrs. Twain. You've been a big help. We appreciate it.
She had no one, Sergeant. No friends, you see. That's why I was suspicious.
Yeah, well, if we need any further statements, Mrs. Twain, we'll be in touch. Thanks again.
Peter started fooling around. Bobby tried to grab him, and they both fell. All Peter's fault. I'm so cross with him.
Well, as soon as he gets better, you give him a good hearty.
Well, this boy can't go back by air. He's got a fractured skull.
Yes, I know that.
Have to splint this leg right away.
That's a fractured leg and maybe some other damage. We'll have to fly him into hospital as quickly as possible and make a thorough check.
Well, you can't fly Bobby anywhere, not with a fractured skull. I mean, the air pressure would be too much.
That had occurred to me. You drive us into town, lad?
Yes, yeah, sure thing, Doc.
Sorry to do this on your first day, Tom, but we'll need to split up.
Well, look, I'll do the road trip. I mean, it's going to be a long, hot drive and...
And what? You think I'm a little delicate?
No, that's not what I...
You're the one about an old dog for a hard road, I suppose. Oh, Gene. Dr. Callaghan will fly in with you and young Peter.
Oh. How's that, mate?
That's like bloody hell.
Peter!
Oh, there may be some internal bleeding in the leg, Mrs. Hennessy.
Sorry to do this to you on your first day.
Most inconsiderate. Haven't even unpacked yet.
After all this, you might decide not to.
Oh, no, you don't get rid of me that easily. The agreement is for 6 months.
What is it?
Hurting.
Where does it hurt, Pete?
My stomach.
Ah! What's happening?
Increase the drip quickly.
That won't work.
What?
The stethoscope won't work because of the engine noise.
I want to talk to Andy.
Use the headset. What's happening? How can a broken leg do this to him?
There must be some other condition.
Peter, it's all right.
Andy.
Yes?
We've got a problem back here. How far are we from base?
About 25 minutes.
Well, I'm going to have to operate as soon as I get back. What's the procedure?
You just let me know what you want and I radio ahead.
Mike Sierra Foxtrot, what's your current ETA?
Estimate Cooper's crossing airstrip 1435 hours. A confirmation the boy's blood type is O negative.
Roger, Mike Sierra Foxtrot, everything underway. Meanwhile, will all other radio traffic keep this channel clear?
Stand by for further instructions.
BP 80, pulse 120. He will be all right. Will he be all right?
We'll operate immediately we get him to hospital. Should be another 15 minutes.
BP 60, pulse 130.
Explanation for this terrible thing. As soon as we know the facts.
There's only one fact that matters, isn't it?
Please let me know if there's anything I can do.
Kate, can you drive me to Edna's?
UN Australian. And his name is. Bruce! Bruce!
G'day.
And this is Bruce's son, Barry.
Just call me Baz.
Are you in charge of the marquee, Bruce? Take it down, please. We won't be needing it now. Come with me, young lady. I wish you'd do what she says. Bruce.
Whatever will they think of now?
Anne-Marie's been on my books for, probably about 12 years now. Oh, it can't be that long. Oh, no, 12. She's been a definite asset to the agency. She's certainly a star of the stable. We do mainly specialise in junior talent, but we just go so far back. Oh, and I do think she shows great promise. She's very creative. She's extremely enthusiastic. I think Anne-Marie's still trying to find that special thing that Anne-Marie's good at, because she's got so many strings to her bow. She's done lots of bits and pieces.
Oh, sorry, Tommy. If there's anything I can do...
You organised the protest.
Yes, and it was peaceful.
You completely blocked the door to the clinic.
Our aim is to make these women think twice.
By intimidating them?
I pray every day and every night that God will show them the error of their ways. Tom, you understand.
And what was Nelson doing there?
I really have no idea.
You didn't recruit him?
We don't need to recruit anyone. People join us because they're willing to stand up and do the right thing. We don't need this new clinic.
He's just a boy.
A boy who knows right from wrong, something many of our younger people have forgotten. I'm very sorry about what's happened to him, Tommy. But shouldn't you be speaking to the poor woman who ran him down?
Oh, Mrs. Toogood, what can we do for you?
Beryl.
Brought you all in a little something.
Is that the lemon or the passion fruit?
Passion fruit, with the lime swirls.
We can't accept that.
We can't?
It's payola.
It's a cake.
Just a token of my appreciation for any little difficulty we may have caused yesterday.
Might not be a good time, Beryl.
But at least take some home for young Nelson. Be a pity to waste it.
Mrs. Price, what can we do for you?
Keep her and her cronies away from my daughter.
I really don't know what you mean.
Had one on my doorstep last night.
I certainly didn't send anyone around.
That teacher, the creepy one.
Wendell Story.
wanted to talk to Caitlin Whittaker in her sermon there on the front step, if I'd let him. Can I charge him with trespassing?
Did he leave when you asked him to?
I didn't give him much choice.
No, unfortunately, he can't.
Wendell's a good boy, not very eager.